Hello, my name is Hiroyuki Ishii, and today I will talk about dynamic tracing tools on ARM and AArch64 platform. I'm working at Panasonic's automotive section in Japan as a Linux engineer, and recently I've been engaged in Linux debugging tools. And this talk aims to promote the dynamic tracing tools in embedded. I will start this talk with an introduction of the dynamic tracing capability and tools, including recent updates. And I also introduce a porting example of the dynamic tracing tools to AArch64 platform. Okay, so I'm working at Panasonic and developing IVA products in vehicle infotainment products with Linux. Actually, Panasonic is a tier one IVA supplier for various OEMs and is also the largest IVA supplier in the world. And recently, we are using Linux on ARM CPU in several IVA products. The current IVA system is getting much larger and much more complex. IVA systems nowadays have really massive features such as navigation, voice recognition, and multimedia streaming and ripping, database networking, connectivity, and so on and so on. And to meet those wide requirements, we are trying to use the latest hardware such as ARMv8 64-bit architecture, as known as AArch64, and also a newer version of Linux kernel like 4.x, which has the latest drivers for AArch64. Still, both of them are not in product yet, but will be in near future. And also, we are trying to use hundreds of various open source components. But in result, the software increases to the tens of million lines of unfamiliar source code. They are consisting of open source and in-house code. But sometimes in-house code is much harder to be understood than open source. And in such case, one of the big issue is debugging. Tons of unknown issues occur when we are running such a big system, and the debugging becomes terribly complex. In other words, we have to find out the cause of the issue from the hundreds of components or tens of million lines of code. So we need an advanced approach for this problem. How can we debug the tens of million lines of unfamiliar source code? And the answer is dynamic tracing. So what's the dynamic tracing? In short, it's a way of watching every function at any time. Even there are a few exceptions, such as inlined-out functions, but we can watch almost every functions, and it's not only in kernel, but also in user space. And some more details. The word dynamic means the capability to attach to a live system, and it also means no precaution is required, such as pre-editing source code. So it gives us a flexible and ad hoc way of analysis. And the word tracing means the two of the systems or programs behavior. For example, you can monitor a particular function which you are interested in, such as a system call or a scheduler or virtual memory or file system or networking or some user process or libraries or whatever. And you can also do some profiling, such as interval sampling of the system stats. And also, you can do record of the function call history for the sake of the roughly testing functions or exploring unfamiliar source code. And why now dynamic tracing in embedded? The biggest reason is the powerful tracing capabilities that Linux 4.x has. We finally got the key features for the dynamic tracing in mainline kernel, such as kprobes for AArch64 or BPF. They are already mainlined, and uprobes for AArch64, it is almost ready to merge. Another reason is tools. The dynamic tracing tools are remarkably improving in past 2 or 3 years by supporting the latest technologies such as BPF. And what are the advantages? First, you can gain advanced observability. You can break down the issues quickly and clearly, even if it's a kind of complicated issues or unknown issues. And second is the less installation cost. There are no need to change the product code for dynamic tracing. It's really efficient because we have to analyze tons of codes. So let me briefly introduce what we can do with dynamic tracing. On Linux system, there are many observability tools, and most of them are kind of traditional tools, such as TOP, or PS, or BMStat, or FREE, or STRS, or LSOF, or many other tools. And most of these tools are designed for analyzing most of these tools are designed for a single purpose. In other words, for analyzing particular subsystems in kernel. By contrast, the dynamic tracing tools can trace and observe the whole system, and it's not in only in kernel and also in user space. And those dynamic tracing tools works thanks to the various tracing frameworks in Linux, such as trace points and kprobes and uprobes and ftrace and perf events and BPF. All of them, other than BPF, is not so new features. But BPF is pretty new and is becoming most important features in dynamic tracing. Because it reduces the overhead in dynamic tracing. BPF can provide a way of processing trace data inside of the kernel. So we can summarize the trace data before dumping them to user space. This is really efficient because the data transfer can be a large overhead. And reducing the overhead, the BPS makes the many things practical. which were previously impossible. And I also have to explain that there are some types of dynamic tracing tools. First is programmer merge tool, and second, not programmer merge tool, and third, single purpose tools. The first one provides a programmer framework for Linux, for tracing, so we can write our own tool with this tool. And also, they have some bundled script as individual analyzing tools. And second one is a kind of all-in-one tracing tool. And it can a lot of tracing things due to the command line arguments. And the third one is the, just a group of individual analyzing tools. So let's see the, some example of a dynamic tracing tools. This is a perf tools, a kind of single purpose tools. It contains the, about dozen of commands. It's not so many, but it covers the minimum subsystems for performance analysis. And this is an example of BCC. It's a kind of programmer merge tool. It contains really many commands and can approach to many subsystems to achieve the advanced analysis. So let's see the, some practical example of dynamic tracing to dynamic tracing usage with the, some commands of BCC and perf tools. OpenSnoop traces the open system calls and prints all the file open events in system at real time. In this example, there are some building process on the other on the other terminal, and OpenSnoop is tracing the file opens by BCC and configure and many other commands. This tool is useful for analyzing file-related issues, such as issues with config files or dynamic libraries. ExecSnoop traces the new processes via exec syscalls. It's similar to OpenSnoop. And this example also shows the, some building process. And this tool is useful for analyzing a kind of the short reaming process like this. So you can easily find out the, which command execution was failed. BIOSnoop traces the block device I/O with PID and latency, and there are some more informations like sector location and size. This tool is useful for analyzing storage issues, such as performance issues or issues of the drivers. Func graph. This prints the kernel function call graph and durations. This example shows the in this example, it's tracing the child function calls of do sys open with limiting the max depth to 3. It's really useful to not only for troubleshooting, but also for understanding how kernel function works. Func count. This counts the kernel and user function calls. In this example, it's tracing the functions of bash, which name is started with set. you can easily find which function is most frequently called, and it's useful for reducing CPU consumption. Trace. This command traces arbitrary functions with filters. Example on upper side is tracing the sysread function in kernel and filtering the result with its argument value. And example on lower side is tracing the readline function in bash and printing the return value. This tool is useful for any kind of ad hoc analysis. And frame graph. Frame graph shows the stack function stack history of the system-wide. You can easily find out which function is time-consuming, and you can roughly check the sanity of functions. And there are many other useful tools with dynamic tracing. If you were interested in, I recommend it to see the BCC's project page. So next, I will introduce a summary and recent updates of dynamic tracing tools. The first one is perf tools. It's a kind of single-purpose observability tools. And actually, this project seems to be closed. And the most of the tools are ported to BCC by the author. But this tool is still useful because of its few dependencies. If you can't get worked the other dynamic tracing tools, and it's because of the dependencies, I think it's worth to try perf tools. But the cons are first, it has the direct dependency on the Intel architecture in each script. So you have to fix each script one by one to port them. And also, the scripts are less customizable. And this is an example of the script of perf tools. And this is a source code of OpenSnoop. It's a bash script, and it's a bit long, so it's truncated here. But what this script is doing is creating a probe point to a sysopen function by using kprobes interface. And the printing the arguments and filtering out the result with awk script. The second one is systemtap. Systemtap is really powerful, programmable match tool with a nice language. It has its language is high level and less arch dependent and easy to understand. And also, systemtap is ready for AArch64, basically. But there are several cons. First, it takes a long time before running a script because it runs its script with building them into the kernel loadable module. And also, systemtap is relatively unsafe. Systemtap sometimes causes the kernel panic. Systemtap runs the user's script as a kernel module. But there are some people who is working for the systemtap's BPF support. And both cons might be fixed with BPF support. So I'm really expecting for the release. And this is the example of systemtap script, and is also the source code of OpenSnoop. It's really simple, but it can do almost same thing as a perf tools one. The next is BCC. BCC is a promising BPF front end tool and is under really active development. Its biggest pro is the low overhead and extra capabilities thanks to BPF. And also, it supports various front ends such as Python or Lua or Go or C++. And also, it contains really many useful scripts. But the con of BCC is a lower level language. To write a BCC script, you have to write the BPF program in stricted C code. So scripts get a bit wrong. And also, the BCC script has a direct dependency on Intel architecture. This is the same problem as perf tools. This is an example of BCC script. And it's doing counting the BFS functions in kernel. The left side is a BPF program and doing a in-kernel summarizing such as a count up. And the other is Python script and doing creating a probe point and loading BPF program and doing some exception handlings and printing results. And next is Pry. Pry is upcoming BPF front-end tool. And so far, it's only one tool with a high-level language and BPF support. But Pry is still in the beta version, and it's relatively unstable. And also, its development seems relatively slow because of single author. And also, AX64 is not supported yet. So it seems fairly far from the practical use, especially on AArch64 platform. But still, it's an interesting tool. This is an example of Prize script and its output. It is doing system-wide counting of the all system calls. This is a really modern language and seems to easy to write. The last one is perf. Perf is a performance analyzing tool and is in Linux source code, source tree. Its pros is, first, it's reliable and ready to use on many architecture because it's in tree and it is heavily maintained. And also, it has advanced capabilities such as CPU statics by PMU. Although it's a kind of tricky thing. And also, BPF already has a BPF support, although it's pretty tricky too. And the cons are, first, perf is not much programmable. And second, perf requires relatively much keystrokes other than other tools. So totally, I feel it that perf is relatively tricky to master. But it depends on your preference. And this is a summary of tools. Please note, this is just my personal opinion and means no special recommendation. And also, please note, there are many other useful dynamic tracing tools other than this. So far, BCC seems to be a good choice because it has a programmable interface and it supports BPF completely. But the other tools has other advantages. So you can make a choice of tools according to your use case. So the last section is porting. In this section, I will introduce an AX64 porting example of BCC. And actually, I'm also trying to port several other tools than BCC. And currently, perf tools are partially available. And also, all patches are put on my GitHub. And I'm going to update them continuously. So the environment for this is my environment for porting. The hardware I used is the Salvato X board, which is a reference board of the Runesas Alka Gen 3 SoC, and is integrated in AX64. And I also used the Linux kernel maintained by Runesas, and its version is 4.9. And we need some more extra kernel patches because uprobe for AX64 is not mainlined yet. And the patches are developed by Pratish Anand at Red Hat. And this is the whole kernel configs I added for porting. Please note, I use the common configs for every dynamic tracing things. So there might be the unnecessary configs for BCC. And the other environment is this. there are only one thing to note is multi-loop environment. The UDA land I used, which is based on Yocto 2.x, is the libraries installed to lib64 directory, such as /lib64 or /uda/lib64. This is a bit unusual thing for OSS open sources, so it might cause a problem during building. And this is the version of BCC and noteworthy dependencies. BCC uses LLVM and CLang for building compiling the BCC bytecode. And Python is optional but strongly recommended. This is porting steps. Please note there are some temporary workaround so far. And I'm working hard to correct them. And versions of LLVM and CLang is this. And the first step is cross-compiling LLVM and CLang. This is instructions for checkout. And please note that dollar mark means the commands on the host PC, and sharp means the target board. And this is the build instructions. Here we are using the CMake for a build configuration, and there are many options for cross-compiling, such as sysroot path or lib64 directory or GCC as compiler and so on. And there are also small tips. If you are trying to build LLVM and CLang for the first time, I will recommend not to use build parallelization because it might cause an OOM error. The linking phase it consumes really huge memory. And next step is cross-compiling BCC. This is almost same as LLVM and CLang. But I had a first problem here during BCC's cross-compilation. And the error, and it says some error occurs during finding libraries, and the path doesn't point the lib64 directory. So this is a kind of lack of multi-loop support in BCC's CMake file. So this is the patch. This is a patch for this problem. And you also also need to add this option for enabling this set property. And now BCC's cross-compilation was succeeded, but we had another problem when I running the hello world of the BCC. And it's saying interpreter has not been linked in. This is caused by the lack of the BPF module in CLang. And to fix it, we need to fix 2 points. The first is it has not built on the LLVM and CLang's compilation. And also, BCC doesn't try to link it even if it will exist. So the fix of LLB and CLang side is the removing LLVM target arch and LLVM target to build option. It seems to be a really it seems to be really necessary, but in this case, it's obstructing because these options make the BPF module not to be built. And the cross compilation still works well because of this another option. And the fix in the BCC side is a bit difficult. Something about the module detection seems to be wrong in the BCC's CMake file, but so far I couldn't fix it correctly. So this patch is a kind of the quick hack, and it forces BCC binaries to link all LLVM modules, and so BCC binaries becomes needlessly huge. So I'm working to fix it soon. And we have another problem with running scripts. It's saying the inline assem not supported. This is caused during the building process of the BPF programs from the C code, and it's not a bug. It's a kind of a specification. So we need to remove the inline assem call, but where the inline assem code? I cannot find it. And fortunately, there are person who are suffering with same problem on mailing list, and I found that inline assem code is existing in the kernel header. And header is this is the header, and assem code is here, and this is only the definition of the macro with assem code, and it's never used during compiling BCC bytecode. So it can be removed with compilation switch. It's really an ugly hack, but is effective. And to be correct, should be fixed in BCC or maybe in CLang to. Filtering out all assem code before building BPF bytecode. So I will try it. And now BCC works fine. And the Hello World program and several scripts worked fine. But unfortunately, the OpenSnoop script doesn't work well. So some scripts require extra fix in each script, as I mentioned before. So we need to fix some arch dependencies. And in case of OpenSnoop, we need to fix the probe point mismatch, because AArch64 kernel uses the sysopenArch function instead of sysopen. So this is the patch. It's slightly long, but simple. It's detecting the architecture with uname minus m, uname minus m, and if the arch name starts with AArch64, switching the target function to sys operand. So finally, OpenSniff works fine. And I'm trying to port the other two as same as OpenSniff. And the summary of my talk. I really hope that if you try some dynamic tracing tools after this talk, there are good selection of tools such as BCC and systemtap and perf tools and many other tools. And I'm really looking forward to the BPF front-end tools with high-level language. It might be BCC or perf extension or systemtap's BPF support or PRI or the other two. And the future work, I will correct those workarounds and also try to port much more scripts and do testing. And also I'm preparing to contributions, and maybe I will try to port the tools to Linux V 3.x and AMP 7. And this is references. I want to say many thanks to Brendan Gregg. Brendan Gregg at Netflix. He's a leading engineer of the dynamic tracing and performance analysis. So that's my talk. Thank you. any questions? Where?
How can we stay up to date with your activities in this?
Oh, yeah. I'm just thinking about it. Please see the, this account.
Okay.
Please forward this account. Okay. Yeah. And I'm going to join the mailing, some remaining list, like a BCC or something. Not yet. Yeah.
Another question. So you talked a lot about tracing. Have you seen anything in your travels that speak to detecting memory leaks inside the kernel, for example?
Please say it again.
Do any of these technologies or techniques allow you to detect memory leaks?
I might have the example. There are two named Memric in BCC project, and it detects all malloc call and free call and detects the or memories, so you can try it.
And does that work inside the kernel as well, or is that a user space
thing? Actually, I have not tried it yet. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
What does mean security in the context? I mean, you have this list of tools. Some are secure and some are not secure. What kind of security? You load code into the kernel, so I guess it's inherently kind of unsecure. I mean, when you do that.
Yes. you were right. And it's a future work for me, and I'm not so concerned about security so far. It's future work. Any other questions? Okay, so thank you very much.